a claim documented against the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, for the benefit of the Informed Consent Action Network, ICAN, and advice, Robert F. Kennedy Jr., has uncovered some irritating certainties about antibodies, the pharmaceutical business, and Congress. TFTP reports, after an uptick in claims in the 1980s, the antibody makers basically held the administration prisoner and debilitated to quit making immunizations except if the legislature assumed on liability for antibody damage claims. The National Childhood Vaccine Injury Act of 1986 was then sanctioned, which made the citizens obligated for wounds caused by immunizations and not the makers. This expulsion of risk has made the motivating force to turn out new antibodies with next to no testing, as the organizations don't need to stress over monetary hardships for harming individuals, which thusly has molded the circumstance that we wind up in today. Over the most recent two decades, we've seen a close to 300% expansion in the quantity of CDC-suggested antibodies. As the antibody organizations never again had a motivating force to thoroughly test the well-being of their immunizations, the obligation of testing antibody security was then passed to the U.S. government. Presently, a claim recorded against the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, in the interest of the Informed Consent Action Network, ICAN, and advice, Robert F. Kennedy Jr., has uncovered that the half-yearly reports for these well-being thinks about, as required by Congress, have never happened. As indicated by the public statement from ICAN, the 1986 Act conceded phenomenal, financial invulnerability to pharmaceutical organizations for wounds caused by their items and killed monetary impetus for them to make safe antibody items or enhance the well-being of existing immunization items. Congress in this way charged the Secretary of HHS with the unequivocal obligation to guarantee immunization security. Consequently, since 1986, HHS has had the essential and for all intents and purposes sole obligation to make and guarantee enhancements in the permitting, producing, antagonistic response revealing, research, security and viability testing of antibodies, keeping in mind the end goal to decrease the danger of unfriendly immunization responses. Keeping in mind the end goal to guarantee HHS meets its immunization security commitments, Congress required as a component of the 1986 Act that the Secretary of HHS present a half-yearly report to Congress itemizing the enhancements in antibody well-being made by HHS in the former 2 years. ICAN in this way recorded a Freedom of Information Act, FOIA, ask for on August 25, 2017 to HHS looking for duplicates of the semi-annual reports that HHS should submit to Congress, beginning in 1988. Enumerating the upgrades it made like clockwork to immunization security. HHS stonewalled ICAN for 8 months, declining to give any substantive reaction to this demand. What ICAN found when the HHS was at last compelled to turn over the archives demonstrating they have done the required investigations of antibody well-being was stunning. They never recorded the report, not once. Because of the FOIA ask for and ensuing claim, the HHS restored an announcement taking note of that no such records existed. ICAN was thusly compelled to document the claim to constrain HHS to either give duplicates of its half-yearly immunization well-being reports to Congress or let it be known never recorded these reports. The aftereffect of the claim is that HHS needed to at long last and shockingly concede that it never, not in any case once, presented a solitary semi-annual answer to Congress itemizing the changes in antibody well-being. This says a lot to the earnestness by which immunization security is dealt with at HHS and uplifts the worry that HHS hasn't the foggiest with regards to the real well-being profile of the now 29 dosages, and developing, of antibodies allowed by multi-year of age. Rather than presenting the reports to Congress on the security of antibodies, HHS has dedicated its assets to expanding immunization take-up. As ICAN clarifies. Conversely, HHS takes alternate parts of the 1986 Act, which require advancing immunization take-up, genuinely, burning through billions yearly and creating a constant flow of reports on the most proficient method to enhance antibody take-up. Deplorably, HHS has concentrated on its commitment to build immunization take-up and safeguard against any case antibodies cause hurt in the National Injury Vaccine Compensation Program, otherwise known as the Vaccine Court, to such an extent, to the point that it has deserted its antibody well-being duties. On the off chance that HHS isn't, as affirmed in court this week, notwithstanding satisfying the straightforward undertaking of recording a half-yearly given account of immunization well-being changes, there is little expectation that HHS is really handling the substantially harder activity of really enhancing antibody security. What this implies? This does not mean, as some have guaranteed, that the U.S. government has never led an antibody well-being test. Spreading this disinformation completes a damage to the people at ICAN and RFK Jr. Different offices have put out reports on immunization well-being. Be that as it may, a significant number of these divisions are staffed with and even headed up by previous insiders from the antibody organizations. Moreover, it uncovered a major issue inside HHS. Throughout the previous three decades, HHS neglected to document these reports and Congress had no issue with it. Furthermore, over not documenting the required security reports, the HHS abided by the piece of the NCVIA that expected them to expand antibody take-up, plainly showing where their needs lie: dissemination to begin with, well-being second.